guys, it's Haley, and today I'm going to be showing you my Manhattan room tour. As you've known, if you listen to my podcast,
which you should,
Skinny Stories to Tell in the Dark, available on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, and many more platforms, always linked below. I'll put a nice little picture on the screen. If you've listened to my podcast or watched my last video, you would know I moved to an apartment in Manhattan. So today I'm just going to be showing you a little Manhattan apartment room tour. So yeah, let's just get on into it. Welcome to my room. We're gonna start off with my huge entryway, I know, but on my door I have an over the door hanging rack thing for some of my coats. They don't fit in my closet. These are just a few of the puffy ones, and yeah, I just hang them on the door to save space, you know, life hack. And then moving to the left, I have this piece of wall decor. I don't know what to call it, but I just keep like Polaroids and pictures and stickers on it. And below that I have my fun little mirror. I got it in the trash behind my old apartment building. We love, you know, saving money. And then if we move to the right, I have my crescent moon sign. I had it at my dorm at FIT, if you guys recognize it. It's battery powered, it lights up. I don't turn it on a lot, but it's cute, you know, for the entryway. And then below that, for the fall, I got a 99 cent little cinnamon broom from Trader Joe's. It's really cute and it makes my room smell great, so that's also always a great plus. Now, once we're moving past the little entryway to the right, here's a little quick overview of my room. It's pretty spacious for Manhattan, still tight, but it fits everything I need, you know, it's cute. Under my bed, I have storage bins. That really helps as well with just keeping things somewhere. And then to the right of my bed, I don't have any other place to put it, so I have my backpack where I put my school stuff in, obviously, and then my big umbrella that doesn't fit in my closet. So then above that, I have a little Paris sign. I got this off Etsy. It was supposed to be bigger and then it turned out really small, but it's still cute for decor and such. Then I have my Polaroid, and there was actually a nail already in the wall, which came in clutch, so I just hung it up there, and it's cute, you know, functional and cute. And then RIP my air plants. I think they're dead, but it's fine. And then moving it towards my bed, I'm gonna walk past it to the closet. So this is a very Manhattan thing. My closet hits my bed. It doesn't open fully, but it's all fine. In my closet, it's not really that exciting. I could do a closet tour, but it's kind of a mess. I just have all my coats, and then below the coats I have my hamper full of my dirty clothes, and then all my shoes in the bottom. And then above that I just keep like accessories and towels and extra stuff. And then to the left of my closet on this wall, I just have a collage, kind of, I don't know how to describe it. It has different stickers I've collected, little Polaroid pics, some pics of me and my friends, shout out you guys, and yeah, just kind of different random memorabilia and just knickknacks and stuff that are kind of cute to put on the wall. So now, as for my actual bed, I don't remember where everything's from. I think I got my sheets from like Bed Bath & Beyond and some of the pillows from Bed Bath & Beyond or Target. I know the fuzzy blankets from Target and the pillowcase covers are from Target, so are my curtains. Also, I kind of fucked up on these. One's longer than the other, but it's fine. I was tired when I was moving, and then I bought them on different days because I had trouble getting them up, but it's fine. The best part of my room is my view. You can see the little Empire State Building. I don't know why I'm calling it little. It's not little at all, but it's cute. Then this is my shelf. I like how this room has a lot of window shelf space. I have my essential oils over here. This pack has a lot of fall ones, so that's really fun. And yeah, I'm burning the pumpkin spice one a lot. And then next to that I keep one that I got from a store in Portland, which smells so good. And then I have a pumpkin. I went to a pumpkin patch last weekend. I don't know if you guys saw on Instagram. It was a fun time. Then I have this plant, which I got from Whole Foods, which is cute. And then another little pumpkin I got from Whole Foods, and my aloe plant. And if you see those pieces broken off, it's literally because I burnt my forehead doing my hair and I broke the aloe plant and put my own aloe on it. It felt like the plant really was worthwhile at that point. Then I got this organizer thing just because I had to get a magazine for class. For my advertising class, we have to take in ads. And then I have like my women's writing readings back here, and then I just have a random notebook and the actual magazine for the class, and then a candle from Kauai that Jenna got me. Shout out Jenna, I brought it to New York. It smells so good, thank you. So now here's my room kind of from this perspective, so you can see when you're facing the bed, you know. And then moving to my desk area, it's the same desk from my old apartment, except I didn't do a room tour there, but whatever. So then I just keep Polaroids up here. The wall for some reason doesn't like the double-sided tape, so they always fall down, but I put them up for this video even though they literally have all fallen down after the video, but it's fine. And then other than that, I have a hydro flask on my desk, and then I got this little thing to put all my vitamins and just kind of skincare and random stuff in on the top. And then on the bottom little section thingy, I just keep gum, the Laneige sleeping lip mask, and then like Q-tips and stuff. And then I have makeup here. I can do a makeup collection if you want. I don't have a lot with me here in New York. My makeup mirror,
and then just more makeup products and stuff. I got a bunch of Glossier stuff, which is super fun. And then I just have a little pumpkin and my lamp. Yeah, Whole Foods came in clutch, and Trader Joe's. They have like 60 cent pumpkins. And I also keep my laptop, and then under my desk is just random shoes. My suitcase normally doesn't go there, but I just got back from a trip. And then I also have my outlets and stuff. I have one big thing so I can plug in a bunch of stuff. And then also there's some more plants back here and another pumpkin. You know, we love just having a lot of greenery in the room. And then it's, oh, my essential oil diffuser. Love this. Recommend it over candles for sure. Then I just have a box of tissues because I'm sick. And then my fan. I don't have, there's like room for an AC unit, but it's much cheaper to just have a fan and it works just as well. And here's my dresser. And on top of it, I kind of use it for storage of miscellaneous things. I keep sunglasses here laid out, you know, oh so nicely. Then I have this rack thing, which I have like a choker, like headbands, necklaces, and kind of earrings and stuff. Lotion, crystal, an apple cider diffuser thingy, smells so good. And then I was showing you guys, smells so good. And then I just have like a jewelry plate and my different perfumes. This is the one I got from Urban Outfitters. I wear this every day now. It smells really good, very classy. And my jewelry and earrings and stuff. And then a fake plant Jenna got me in like freshman year of high school. And yeah, other than that, I just have this Polaroid thing. It lights up, but it's a more efficient way, I guess, to put my Polaroids up. It's pretty cute, some nice decor, but that's pretty much my room.
Hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you did, be sure to subscribe down below, give this video a thumbs up, and I will catch you next time.